Hey guys, did you know that China has earned the moniker Infrastructure Marvel? This title isn't a criticism, it's a reflection of how foreigners marvel at the rapid pace and cutting-edge technology behind China's megaprojects. As we're all aware, China has undergone unprecedented transformations, particularly in its eagerness to build megaprojects to cater to its ever-growing population. Over the past three decades, China's infrastructure landscape has seen a truly astonishing evolution, defying expectations and leaving the global community in awe. Starting from humble beginnings, China's infrastructure journey stands as a testament to its unwavering dedication to progress and innovation. Today, we'll explore some recent megaprojects in China that will absolutely astound you. But before we dive into our discussion, we kindly ask for your support by liking this video and subscribing to Machine Eye. Your thoughts matter to us, and we invite you to share your opinions in the comments below. Without further ado, let's embark on an extraordinary journey. You may already be familiar with China's reputation for colossal infrastructure endeavors, encompassing not only remarkable buildings and transportation systems but also groundbreaking technology and energy initiatives. The first megaproject we want to introduce is the Chinese International Space Station. This is China's very own space laboratory and the second operational space station in orbit after the Russian Soyuz. The Chinese International Space Station consists of three modules with a total mass of approximately 90 tons and a design lifespan of 10 years. It will conduct various scientific research and technological experiments across multiple fields and invite astronauts from around the world to explore the mysteries of space together. Currently, five of its components have been launched, and six astronauts have conducted long-term stays and work on board. By the end of 2022, it's expected to complete all module launches and dockings and officially begin its operations. This project not only solidifies China as a space superpower, but also enhances our understanding of the universe. Would you like to visit the Chinese International Space Station? I certainly would, but I need to shed some weight first, or I won't make it onto the spaceship. The second megaproject we'd like to introduce is the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge. This is a colossal sea-crossing bridge connecting Hong Kong, Zhuhai, and Macau, stretching over 55 kilometers, equivalent to 13 Manhattan Islands put together. It cost 126.9 billion renminbi to build, which is like buying 1,269 luxury mansions. The bridge employed advanced bridge-building techniques, including land reclamation, an ultra-long underwater tunnel, complex tower structures, high-performance steel, and concrete among others. Among them, steel consumption reached an astonishing 420,000 tons, which is equivalent to building 60 Eiffel Towers. From an overall perspective, the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge is primarily composed of three parts: a bridge, a tunnel, and artificial islands. It starts from the Hong Kong port, stretches westward across the Lingdingyang Sea, and connects Zhuhai and Macau. The total length is 55 kilometers, with the sea crossing section covering 42 kilometers, including both sea bridges and underwater tunnels. Artificial islands connect the bridge and tunnel segments in the middle of the sea. How are these artificial islands constructed? The foundation of the artificial islands was formed using 120 steel cylindrical structures, each with a diameter of 22 meters, a height of 39 meters, and a weight of 600 tons. These cylinders were prefabricated on the shore, transported to the sea by ships, and then sunk in the construction area of the artificial islands. The sand was filled inside them, creating a reclaimed land in the middle of the sea, forming the land base of the artificial islands. In simple terms, it's like building a massive retaining wall. Once completed, the area of the artificial islands reached 100,000 square meters, larger than 10 standard football fields. After crossing the sea bridge, vehicles can drive into the underwater tunnel. The underwater tunnel of the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge is 6.7 kilometers long, making it the longest submerged tube tunnel in the world. How was the underwater tunnel of the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge constructed? In the 6.7 kilometer underwater tunnel, the deeply buried section is 5,664 meters long and is constructed by connecting 33 sections of reinforced concrete structures known as caissons. These caissons are 180 meters long, 37.95 meters wide, 11.4 meters high, and weigh approximately 80,000 tons, equivalent to the weight of an aircraft carrier. They were sequentially lowered into grooves on the seabed, over 40 meters deep, and then seamlessly connected with an error control of within 2 centimeters. The connected caissons had to ensure they would not leak water for 120 years of use, illustrating the high construction difficulty of this project. During its construction, it faced numerous challenges such as strong winds, tides, earthquakes, navigation protection, and environmental preservation. However, the Chinese didn't give up, and after 10 years of hard work, it was completed in 2018 and was hailed as one of the 7 wonders of the modern world by The Guardian. This bridge not only reduces travel time between the 3 regions, but also promotes economic and cultural exchanges. This project is truly remarkable, turning the 3 regions into an integrated market and making it more convenient for us to travel and shop. Would you like to visit the Hong Kong-Zhuhai-Macau Bridge? I certainly would, but I need to save up some money first, or I won't be able to afford anything there. The third megaproject we'd like to introduce is the Matua Hydropower Station. Located upstream of the Yarlung-Zhangbo River in Tibet, it is the second largest hydropower station in the world, only surpassed by the Grand Inga Dam in the Congo River's Inga Falls. The Matua Hydropower Station has an installed capacity of 16 million kilowatts, double that of the Three Gorges Dam, and an annual electricity generation of 74 billion kilowatt hours, equivalent to 10% of the national hydropower output. The construction of this hydropower station will greatly improve energy supply in Tibet and support the national goals of carbon neutrality and peak carbon emissions. Currently, the project has completed its survey phase and is expected to commence construction in 2022, with operations beginning in 2028. This project is truly eco-friendly, transforming Tibet into an energy-rich region and helping us better protect the environment and combat climate change. Would you like to visit the Matua Hydropower Station? I certainly would, but I need to learn some Tibetan, or I won't be able to communicate when I get there. The fourth megaproject we'd like to introduce is the Cheongzhou Strait Cross Sea Tunnel. This tunnel will connect the Lijiao Peninsula in Guangdong Province with Hainan Island, making it the third largest strait in China after the Taiwan Strait and the Bohai Strait. The Cheongzhou Strait Cross Sea Tunnel will accommodate both passenger and freight rail lines and will be dug 150 meters below sea level without disrupting maritime traffic. The project was approved and construction began in 2019, with a total planned investment of 150 billion renminbi. Once completed, it will link the high-speed rail networks of Guangdong and Hainan, reducing travel time between the two regions and facilitating the development of Hainan's free trade port. This project is truly marvelous, turning Guangdong and Hainan into a one-hour living circle and allowing us to enjoy the sunshine and beaches more quickly. Would you like to visit the Cheongzhou Strait Cross Sea Tunnel? I certainly would, but I need to buy a high-speed rail ticket, or I won't be able to catch a ride there. The fifth megaproject we'd like to introduce is the Hongqi River Project. This is an ecological project that will divert water from the Yarlung-Zhangbo River and Nujiang River to turn 30 to 80 million mu of desert into arable land, effectively solving the problem of aridity. This project will transport water from high-altitude areas in Tibet to the dry regions of Xinjiang without the need for electrical pumping. It will be entirely gravity-fed. The project requires significant investment, 10 times that of the Three Gorges Dam, and is a monumental project of our time with long-term benefits. Currently, it's in the planning stage and has not yet officially started. This project is truly magnificent, turning Xinjiang into an oasis and helping us better protect the environment while increasing food and water resources. Would you like to visit the Hongqi River project? I certainly would, but I'll have to wait until it's completed, or I won't be able to see the water when I get there. Well, that's all for today's video. What do you think of these mega projects in China? Have you ever thought about visiting them in person? If you enjoyed today's video, please give us a thumbs up, leave a comment, and share it with your friends. If you'd like to learn more about mega projects in China or around the world, please subscribe to our channel. We'll see you next time.